Pope Francis had lunch with a bunch of men who think they're women. How do my Catholic friends feel about this on the heels of Francis's move to allow trans baptism godparents?
This is what is trans baptism? That sounds like an abomination. I'm gonna have to look that up and probably make a video about that too. But he's asking for a Catholic perspective, and as some of you may know who watch this channel, I am a Catholic, but a Catholic who is looking into the Eastern Orthodox Church. I have to specify this because the question is, what is the Catholic perspective on this? And it's that this is a threat to Catholic theology, because if you don't know, they have a doctrine that states that the Pope is infallible when it comes to teaching doctrine and when it comes to teaching the faith. He can't say anything heretical. He's protected from doing that. They can't say he's completely infallible and sinless, because that would be heretical on its own. And they're just basically saying popes can be really bad people, but they can never teach anything that is non-Christian. Remember that, okay? Because with Pope Francis going woke now, this is kind of in threat. This is kind of a threat to the theology. And what I mean by he went woke now is he started by trying to appeal to the LGBT crowd with this move. But originally he started with saying things like being gay should not be a death penalty offense, which if you're an honest Christian, I don't think that you should be really opposed to that. I don't see anything wrong with that. But what really made it like the threat to theology that I'm saying it is when he started saying that the church is going to start blessing gay weddings. How can you bless sin? Can somebody explain to me how this is not a heresy? I mean, saying things like it should not be a death penalty offense is one thing. That's not doctrinal. But you can bless a sin? Excuse me? And now with this whole trans lunch thing, it's just proof that he is focused on pandering and trying to get the LGBT crowd to basically not be as hostile towards the church as they are, which is never going to work, by the way, because I think even they see this move for what it is. It's just an attempt to pander. And if wokeness can get into the Catholic Church, which is supposed to be the one true church and the true form of Christianity, then I don't know. That should put some doubt on that, okay? Just saying.